philosophy is a way of thinking and just being naturally inquisitive about the world around us.
The governing rule of the universe and the code of conduct of the Illuminati.
It's the love of wisdom, right?
Philosophy Camp is one of the most unique experiences I've ever had. It's a life-changing experience where you live on a small farm with a great group of people and just explore what it is to live your life.
The training camp of becoming a member of the Illuminati?
No, it's not.
Philosophy Camp is a summer course at the U of M. It's a philosophy course, so you explore pretty essential philosophy questions, but it's also in a residential communal living sort of situation, so you're doing both of those things at once. And doing the course and also feeding chickens and sitting around a campfire.
Staying up till 1 in the morning one night, and having several Chinese girls explain to me what Fei Julio is. And I never understood it, but the explanation just had me dying. And we did a lot of photo sessions where we'd pose. And
can you do that again to the camera? Nice!
Fei Julio.
Being surrounded by approximately 2,000 cats.
See, favorite memory was probably, well, it'd just be a collage of times, just like sitting around the campfire, I think. And we'd been discussing cool things all day, so those would come up, and we would just play stupid games, and yeah, so, campfire times.
I think the weirdest thing I did at Philosophy Camp was we went running one night at like 2 in the morning, barefoot during a rainstorm. And just like ran around and just got super muddy and like slipped and fell a bunch of times and just stumbled around in the dark and just like laughed the entire time. And it was weird, and I don't know who suggested it and why we all did it, but
that sounds really philosophical.
Definitely. Very academic.
Being surrounded by approximately 2,000 cats.
We went out kind of into the fields with a partner, and then one person had to make a frame with their book or with their hands, and they had to describe what they saw, and then the other person had to draw what they were describing, and that was really weird, but, or no, they had to write a poem about what.
Yeah.
And it was kind of weird, but it turned out pretty well for a lot of people, so.
Well, I had never cooked at all. Like, I had never used anything other than microwave to cook. So that was a big first for me.
Cooking for around 30 person, is that a new thing? That's a new thing?
Mostly the format of the course was what was new. Having to make a meal with a whole team of people, that was definitely a new experience for me. So.
We went 2 weeks without internet, completely, like no internet, and that was so strange, like not being able to email people, like I think like a lot of people just assumed I was dead, like not being posting on Facebook all the time. So, yeah, that was a step challenge.
No.
You're with the same group of people for 24 hours a day, so it's like you just have to really get into the rhythm of living with them and interacting with them and making meals and such. So just trying to work out, not get sick of people. Well, you didn't get sick of them, but then you un-got sick of people, and it was new again. So yeah, just going through those cycles and such.
favorite meal at philosophy camp was when the Chinese students made dumplings. So good, so good. And they also hid coins in the dumplings. And if you got a coin in your dumpling, it's supposed to be good luck. And I got the coin and had a very solid year after that. And I think it was the good luck from the coin that really propelled that.
For one day, my group was making lasagna for everyone. And this was the first time for, at least for me, and I thought I did most of the handiwork, and I feel really proud of that. And it tastes real good.
Yeah. There were a lot of good meals. A lot of good meals. Food was really fresh. But I'd say the best was the handmade bread. You know, kneading it from scratch and then baking it. And perfectly fresh and homemade. You made it yourself with your bare hands.
So when I was a student, there were four guys, including me, and 16 girls. So it was pretty good odds, and I had a lot of crushes while I was there. I'll leave it at that.
Dawn? Because she's probably been to more country than any human being, but we have the human being in the world. So that's kind of cool.
Maybe a little bit, but I'm going to take my sip of coffee and my answer there.
Okay. Yes. Yep.
Cool.
Yep.
Yep. Let's stop there. Okay.
I think she's somewhere in India right now. I don't know.
Okay.
No.
Okay. Good.
Think about it every week at least, and I just can't wait to go back and have such a unique place in my heart, and yeah, I miss it.
Yes.
Yeah, sometimes. It was, like I said, it was a lot of fun, and it was pretty challenging at times too, so it was, but just the experience of kind of being down on the prairie, because it was like the perfect time of year to be down there too.
I would say that going to philosophy camp is one of the smartest decisions you can make, because it's such a unique opportunity, and it's going to allow you to grow and really learn more about yourself than any other course you've ever taken. And it's a unique opportunity, and you should really seize it.
If you think you have the potential to become a crazy cat lady or cat man, that's a chance to prove it.
All right, you should check out philosophy camp. You should give it a try. It's kind of a life-changing experience, but you slowly realize how it changes you later on as we keep reflecting back on it. And you'll be challenged, and you might find out the meaning of life. I'm not telling you, you gotta sign up to find out. So.